Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Biochemistry of cell. The collection of various types of molecules which are present inside cell is termed as cellular pool. When you call it cellular pool or you call it biochemistry of cell. The various chemical constituents and molecules present inside cell. When I talk about cell, the functioning of a cell is dependent upon various molecules present inside cell. And these molecules are nothing but water, proteins, carbohydrates, nucleic acids, lipids, and ions. Let's start about nucleic acid. Nucleic acid is of two types, DNA and RNA. DNA is the genetic material or the material which decides about well-being of a cell, how the cell will function, how the cell will look at, the genetic material. RNA, ribose nucleic acid. This is single-stranded RNA which helps to synthesize proteins inside cell. Carbohydrates. An example of carbohydrates in cell would be glucose. Yes, C6H12O6. The same material which is synthesized after the process of photosynthesis. The process of photosynthesis synthesizes glucose, and glucose is a main source of energy for the cell. The next one is lipids. When I talk about lipids, in normal terms, lipids are called as fats. Fats are the basic layers of cell. An example of this would be phospholipid bilayer. Phospholipid bilayer is present at the outer periphery of the cell, and this phospholipid bilayer decides which molecule will get entry inside the cell and which molecule will not get entry inside the cell. Basically, phospholipid bilayers could be hydrophilic or hydrophobic. When I say hydrophilic, it means water loving, and when I say hydrophobic, it means it hates waters. The next molecule could be proteins. Now, when we talk about proteins in normal human life, we say proteins are building blocks of our body. Similarly, inside any cell, proteins are made up of amino acids, and these proteins can do various functions. An example of proteins could be hemoglobin. Yes, the hemoglobin which is present on the RBC cell, and this hemoglobin consists of iron. This hemoglobin helps to carry oxygen molecule. Your RBCs, upon that there is a hemoglobin molecule, and upon that oxygen is present. So whenever and wherever oxygen has to travel, this hemoglobin molecule along with the RBC helps it to travel. Hemoglobin is a type of a protein. Lastly, ions. There are various ions present inside the cell. An example of this could be magnesium, zinc, cobalt, potassium, sodium. Now, potassium and sodium are nothing but channel ions. They form a channel, or you can say a boundary, at the outer periphery of the cell, and they allow or exchange of water molecules or various other constituents like calcium. They also help in neuronal signaling. So all these molecules somewhere help the cell to function in a better way. Now let us see what are the various chemical constituents or biological constituents of a cell. Biochemistry of a cell. The collection of various types of molecules in a cell is termed as cellular pool, or you can say biochemistry of cell. The constituents present inside the cell. The composition of a cell include, or the molecules which are present inside the cell are, water, proteins, nucleic acids, carbohydrates, lipids and iron. The various bioconstituents of a cell are nucleic acid, that is DNA and RNA. DNA is nothing but deoxyribose nucleic acid and RNA is nothing but ribose nucleic acid. DNA is the genetic material of a cell. Carbohydrates, an example of this is glucose, the byproduct of photosynthesis. Proteins, the various type of proteins present inside the cell are primary, secondary and tertiary. These are the structures of protein. An example of protein is hemoglobin. Lipids. Lipids, they form phospholipid bilayer at the outer periphery of a cell. And lastly, ions. An example of this is calcium, potassium, zinc, manganese, which help to form the outer army of a cell. They help to formation of calcium-gated, ion-gated channel ligands or signaling of a cell. So students, in this part we have studied about various bioconstituents of a cell. I hope you all have understood what are the various bioconstituents of the cell and what is their function. Thank you.